question. Last question. Okay, here we go again. With the help of Hashem. So we are in Yoredea Tzadik Aleph, paragraph Hey, and we got to the Rama. So the Rama, no, we went through the Rama until here. Ken. So even if the meat was not salted from both sides, only from one side. In any case that it was salted, enough salt that it will not be eat, you cannot eat it as it is. So it's count as boiling hot. If it was not so salted, so then it will be considered to be cold. Even when it is salted from both sides.
Don't pay attention to me.
Okay, fine. Yes, Shomrim. The Rama says that there is an opinion that holds that we don't really know what is the amount of salt that will make it that it will that is considered to be boiling hot. And therefore, even when it's regular amount of salting, like you put salt to eat something, that will be enough to consider that as hot. And if it's not a big loss, it's good to be stringent even to that opinion. Okay? Going back to the Shulchan Aruch. Maliach ken maliach the Baal El Archa. The amount of salt that people put on something to preserve it when they're going away. Yeah?
Yeah.
So imagine yourself in the old times when people wanted to do Aliyah LaRegel, to come to Yerushalayim.
Yeah.
Right? They have to take all the food with them. They don't know like what exactly they'll find along the way. And they don't have like a fridge or like a, you know, canes or food or whatever. So if they want to take something, they usually have to preserve it with salt. That would be the regular way to preserve things. So that's a big amount of salt. Yeah, that's a big amount of salt. So we have like three levels of salt. Yeah, we have the level of kedetzli, like the amount of salt that you put when you roasting something, which is the regular amount of salt when you're eating something,
yeah?
Put a little bit of salt. Then you have the amount of salt that you put when you want to kosher meat that you want to cook. Thank you. אפילו לאחר שהדיחו, even after you wash the salt off, Avi eino ne'echal mechamat malchot. Still, it's too salty. Yeah, why? Because the salt goes in. Yeah, the salt goes in. It's not only like stays out, it actually goes in and everything becomes to be like very, very salty. You know, there was a few years ago, there was a group of terrorists that they wanted to come into Israel from Jordan, and they wanted to do it by swimming through the Dead Sea. And Baruch Hashem, they got pickled along the way. I don't remember the name of that phenomenon, but there is something that is like that the salt, like in pickles, the salt goes through like in pickles, so it goes in inside and makes everything to be salty. So by staying enough time inside of the water of the Dead Sea, so a human being is like becomes to is dying because they is like this, the amount of salt goes into the blood through the skin. And it, like, so the, it's a, obviously it's not a very nice way to die. So anyhow, that's what we see here also in the food, that even after they you wash it out, the salt, still it's not possible to eat it because it's too salty. So what is the way to eat those things that you preserve in the in with such an amount of salt? You have to actually leave it in like soaking in water for a while, and then the great. And on the other hand, you can't have, you may have to make sure that it's that it will preserve it, right? So the you have to have like experience how to do it. Anyhow. So in a case like that, that it's just the amount that is enough to preserve it. Even if you wash it out, it will still be considered like boiling hot. Yeah. And it will forbid that an amount like a shell. The amount of a shell, you have to peel it out. Okay, is it clear or no? I'll say it over again. I feel that it was not clear enough. Let's say we want to make salted meat to preserve it. Yeah, so we're putting a lot of salt. Yeah. Now we want to eat it, so we wash it out. We wash out the salt. It's still too salty to eat it because the salt is too deep inside. What we need to do to eat it, we have to leave it soaking in water for a while. Yeah, to soak it in water. If we didn't do that, if we didn't soak it in water, so even though we washed it out, still it will be like boiling hot. My nafkamina. If it's boiling hot and it's touching something like milk, like cheese, so it will make prohibition of a shell thick. So you have to peel out a shell thick out of the cheese, out of the meat, right? Yeah. That's basically what he's saying here. Okay. When chiluk ben malech elyon v'tafel tachton le malech tachton v'tafel elyon. There's no difference if the salted is above and the unsalted, tefel, it means like without salt. So if the salted thing is above and the lower is not salted, or lemaliach tachton v'tefel elyon, that the low one is salted and the upper one is not salted. Le'olam ha'maliach mavliya v'tefel v'eino bolea mimeno. Always the halacha is whatever is salted is extracting taste. Okay. Ben chiluk ben ken. Ilkach, so according to that, basar v'gvina meluchim shenagu ze beze. If you have salted meat and salted cheese that are touching each other, both of them have to peel off the place where they touch. If one of them is salted and the other one is not, the salted one needs to be washed and the unsalted one needs to be peeled. Okay. Rama, ויש אמרים, the כל מליחה אנו משארים בשישים. There is those that they say that in any salting, we are measuring in 60. ואין לכמן סימן קופי, כיצד נוהגים. Okay, so later on in תערובות, סימן קופי, we'll see exactly what is the custom. עד תאום הלוח ותמת אפל, when we have something that is kosher, that is salted, and something that is prohibited, that is not salted. Shari, not salted. Uh-huh. Oh, Hashem. Okay. Volume of the Tzalul Nesar HaTaor, when it is liquid, the kosher thing become to be prohibited. Because it's not, it, you cannot eat it because of the salt. He's observing the one, the prohibition that is by him, and both of them are becoming to be prohibited. That's what it says in Mordechi. We have many sources for that halacha. That's only when the kosher is a little bit moisture. אבל אם הוא יבש לגמרי, when it is totally dry, אינו בולע מדבר לך שאצלו, it cannot absorb something that is liquid, that is by him. אם יבשים, if they are dry, אפילו הם מלוכים, even when they are salted, הולכים ולא מחמת מליחה, or they are liquid, not because of מליחה, סגי בעדך, it will be enough to wash them. Okay.
If something, well, let's say we do a summary of this that so basically say here the Schopenhauer said before about if somebody's going like he's going on a long trip, right? And he needs to preserve the in heavy salt.
Right.
So after he does the cleaning up, right, he's not able to eat it. So saying the whole bunch lay low behind, dina ik reteach v'asa kedik tifa.
Right.
So originally, is there like, meaning there's so much salt that there's so much salt originally that he's not able to eat it even afterwards, right?
Right. Right.
So what does he have to do? He has to
like we said, like leave it in water, soak it in water.
It
means to soak it in water.
Okay.
So we got to the mechaber here. אם יבשים אפילו הם מלוכים, הולכים ולא מחמת מליחה, סגי בהדחה. When they are dry, even if they are salted, or they are liquidy, but not because of salted, סגי בהדחה, it will be enough to wash it out. Yeah? רמה. כל ציר מבשר שנמלח, any juice that comes out of meat that was salted, אפילו לא נמלח רק לצלי, even though it was salted only for roast, חשוב רותח, it will be considered to be like boiling hot. וכן אם נפל ציר על הגבינה או על כלי, also if you have that juice of the meat that falls on cheese on a vessel, אוסר, it will be prohibited. אפילו במקום שאין הבשר אוסר, even in a place that the meat doesn't get to be prohibited, ולא נחשב רותח, it will not be considered to be a boiling hot. כל מקום הציר חשוב ואינו נאכל מחמת מלכו. In any case, the juice that comes out is considered to be that it's not possible to eat because of its saltiness. בציר של בשר שאוסר, the juice of the meat that makes the prohibition, שנפל על כלי, that fell on a vessel, צריך הגלה. You have to kosher that vessel now. If it is a clay vessel, you cannot kosher a clay vessel. So you have to break it, that no one will use it. That's, by the way, a big thing, that sometimes people have a vessel that is like clay that you cannot kosher, and they don't want to throw it away because it's a nice vessel. So they want to hang it on a wall or to put it under a pottery in the veranda or something like that, whatever, you know, they have all kinds of ideas like that, which is a nice idea. But lemaise, it can become to be a stumbling block that afterwards they will forget that it was prohibited and they will put it back into the kitchen. So that's why the Rama says it have to be broken. Okay. There is a lenient opinion that you can rely on in the case of a need, that after a year you can use it. So to put it aside for a whole year and then you can take it again to use it, that's opinion of the Chacham Tzvi, which is the father of the Yavetz. Was a very, very big rabbi in Ashkenaz. So he wrote it. And there is many people that are actually relying on that. So when people are getting, like, for example, like chinaware that is like very expensive from their, some relative inheritance, whatever, that they didn't keep kosher, this part of the family or something like that. So there is people that are relying on this leniency to use it because it's a big loss. It's very expensive. You don't want to break it. So you leave it aside for a year and then use it.
So is Klichar considered China?
China were usually considered to be like a clay pot. There is people that they will say that when it has the glazure, so it's more lenient. And it makes sense because you see that it doesn't absorb so much with the glazure. Mm-hmm. But yeah, chinaware is clay with glazure, right? That's what it is. It's like the glazure is like glass. Glazure is like paint that they paint the clay, and then when they put it in the oven, so it becomes to be like glass texture, right? Very, very smooth, right?
It's
no, there is the old-fashioned clay,
right,
that is very rough, right, and it absorbs like liquid, right? You put liquid there, goes into the clay,
okay,
right? When they put glazure on the clay, so it holds the liquid doesn't go in,
okay,
right? Chinaware is clay with glazure, very fine, but it's basically the same material, clay with glazure. Yeah. So there is people that are considered that as regular clay, and there is people they consider that as something that is in between clay and glass, and even within glass there is a machloket between the Ashkenazim and the Sfaradim. Ashkenazim are like stringent to call glass like clay sometimes, that it's like because it's made out of sand glass, right? And Sfaradim, they say that glass is, you see that it doesn't absorb anything, so you don't need to kosher it. You just need to wash it. That's enough. Anyhow, that's we'll discuss those things when we'll get like after Halachot Arvot. So we have like Halachot of Hechsher Kelim. There's a couple of simanim there. So Bezrat Hashem, when we'll get there, so we'll speak about those things in length. But in the meantime, let's just finish here. The Rama, אם לא נפל רק על מקום אחד בכלי עץ קוצר בו קולף מקומו ודיו. If it fell just on one little spot in that vessel, so if it's like something like wood that you can peel the vessel, so you can do that and that will be enough. Yeah.
In actual vessel.
Yeah, you can peel out the vessel. You can, if it's something that you can peel. So. Thick plastic also I think you can peel out. Wood you can peel. glass you can't peel, right? Metal maybe you can, but I don't think that anyone will do that. Anyhow, we have a lot of baritevs here, and we run out of time, so I guess we'll keep it for tomorrow, because we won't be able to do it all now. So Plinia tomorrow will go over this paragraph again with the baritev. Okay, I'm sorry for all of the problems that we had in the class today with the technical issues of the broadcast. Bezrat Hashem, I hope it will be solved soon. Amen.